been here quite a bit in 2009. You're just here with Terry.
Yeah.
And also, you're quite a regular at the coffee ceremony. What are you looking forward to this year?
Terry Stokes, the hypnotist.
Is that what's going on right now?
Yeah. Caught him last year, too. I want to hypnotize the entire band from the maybe six. Later, so much. We're so honored they keep inviting us back. It's always one of the best parties that goes on in Canada. We're always honored to come. We're so excited we even came out to this press conference to help set up the stand. So it's great to be back. We're looking to take it.
And are you heading out right after?
We gotta go back tomorrow morning.
Yeah. Okay. Got
duty calls.
Of course. You guys got another couple of shows coming up after this.
Playing Sarnia Bay Fest day after tomorrow, which is right back in Ontario. Playing in Hampton Beach, New Hampshire, 2 days after that. So it just keeps going. Popping around. We're back over Red Deer, and then a couple of weeks then we're going out to play with Kiss and Halifax.
Oh, wow.
The usual summer chaos.
Yeah, because you guys actually were on tour with Ace Frehley, the one funny, even though I don't believe he's a part of Kiss anymore, is he?
No, he's not anymore. But he's still doing well. You know, we had a great, about 25 dates in the US with him last year.
So,
yeah, he's still doing his thing.
Okay, well, let's go back a little here. You Colin, you have a musician for a father, and he was very encouraging of you guys to follow his footsteps. Has that always been a dream of yours, too?
Yeah, I think so.
Your website.
Oh, website. Okay, wow. Okay.
It's quite descriptive, actually.
I have to read that, I guess. He was an aspiring musician. He wasn't a professional musician, but he was certainly a huge fan. And one thing he definitely taught us to love music. And it was a big influence on us. All our parents had a big influence on us in terms of what music we listened to.
Which is?
Back then it was, there were Beatles records and the Stones records and the Beatles records and the Cambridge records and the Zeppelin records. So that was that sort of formed the core of our influences. And you can sort of hear it in our sound. It's not really a big mystery. But it was always something we wanted to do, when we got together, started getting together as teenagers to play. I think we're so lucky. We're lucky still to be doing it,
Of course. And what do you think you'd be doing if you weren't a musician?
I really have no idea.
Well, you designed the artwork for the new album, right? Would you be an artist?
Yeah.
What about you?
I'd be a hypnotist. And I could still get to come play the stampede.
Yeah, awesome. And actually, your bio also says that you traveled a lot when you were young and you lived in places like the Caribbean.
Yeah.
What was your fondest childhood memory?
That was a lot of fun. And then, I really found memories of Rome and Ignatius, too.
It's all good. And so, your most recent album, No Time for Later, was just released in the States back in April. How has it been received so far?
It's been a slow building. We haven't had the love and support of the industry on there. Has been instrumental in saying it's great for the world we have here. We have certain supporters that are great, and we have certain supporters that are fantastic. So we hope to keep building that and sort of switch it out city by city. We find it frustrating when you get into our band, it's just bad. So we're just trying to get in front of people because that's the way we make our hardcore fans.
Of course, so you have a headline tour in the States coming up, or you just finished?
Yeah, we have a headline tour. We're going to hit out. Connecticut, and we're going to go out to Midwest to Chicago.
Awesome. So one of my favorite songs off of No Time for Later is Man of Two Minds. and Colin has said that this is a scumbag song. I don't know if it's based on any true life situations, but perhaps it's about temptations on the road.
Not at liberty to discuss.
No, do you guys find it hard to keep relationships while you're on tour a lot?
You know, Jack's done really well. Jack's married, and I've been married, and we're all involved in relationships, so it's been, we have really patient, better halves. They really are better halves. We should be known as the lesser halves.
Oh, no, I'm sure that's not true. But yeah, I know you guys are known as one of Canada's hardest working bands. How many days a year do you say you have shows?
We probably have a show about 200 a year. Sometimes not that, but we're making a record. Probably average out something like that, you know, which is a number you might like to see go down someday. Who knows what the secret goes.
Okay, and another song off your new album, I Can't Stop Laughing, has quite a Celtic feel to it. What was the inspiration for that song?
Told us that he was here and he wanted to write a song. So he wanted a song he'd written to his fellows. Yeah, I can't stop laughing.
Awesome. And another good song is Paranoid Freak. What do you guys think they're going to
know? You got the wrong tune.
What are you scared of? What are your phobias?
We're not paranoid at all. So, they only get worse with the time.
That's true.
Okay, and then for this new album also, you added Jeff, your keyboardist, and he came on tour with you to support. Why did you decide to add him?
Sort of a lot of songs that needed to be even some of our older songs benefited from having an extra to play some of the parts that we were trying to get out on guitar, but it was just too bad to get it all. So.
Doing a good job so far?
He's doing great. He's getting right away, Colin.
Awesome. And I also read that Colin was only given one guitar solo. Why is that?
Because I'm just greedy. You know what? There wasn't a lot of guitar solos. I think the last two were fine. And, you know, it actually turned out really cool. And I don't remember why we decided to, but we just did it. Exactly.
Maybe he'll get some more on the next album.
And I get to sing a song.
Any plans for anyone coming out anytime soon?
We're just working on this acoustic record that's going to come out as a DVD and a CD in October. We're in the stages of putting it together still. It's done and the video comes out then. So hopefully, you know, fingers crossed, in October we'll have like an acoustic record. It's going to get 60 bucks. So the greatest hits type thing. I'm logging a bunch of new and rare stuff as well, which is kind of fun. So that'll come out in